Dozens of middle school age girls attended the 10th Camp Calcium at Purdue University. Typical summer camp fare, such as swimming, canoeing, and crafts, were the lure, not the purpose. This year's 3-week camp focused on measuring the effects of vitamin D on calcium absorption. That requires each girl to strictly adhere to a custom diet with precise portions. Food and nutrition professor Connie Weaver has headed 17 years of research that has helped create national calcium intake standards.
We found that boys utilize calcium more efficiently and don't need more calcium to grow their bigger skeletons. We found that blacks utilize calcium more efficiently than whites. We found that dietary salt, it causes you to excrete more calcium, and so you're more at risk for osteoporosis if your salt intake is high.
Weaver says the camp teaches the girls to eat healthy and the importance of exercise. It also prompts them to think of the future.
Like, where are they going to college? What might they study? Because they're exposed to so many disciplines during camp.
The girls' most in-depth exposure to science comes as technicians measure the length, shape, position, and density of their bones. Cassandra Simpson knew that a lot would be required of her at the camp, but the memory of her grandmother falling and breaking her hip helped motivate her.
I just figured that I would help out studies instead of just sitting at home or going to a camp that's just not doing anything.
13-year-old Angelica Alaberas said what she learned at Purdue will carry into her lifestyle when she goes home to South Bend.
Try to like balance out my meals and like not eat like most of the time and to exercise more, because like we walk like most of the places.
That's the kind of changes Weaver hopes for. 80% of all fractures occur in women, a stat Weaver traces directly back to calcium-deficient diets among teenage girls. The typical girl needs 4 daily servings of dairy for optimum long-term bone health. That's twice the amount camp calcium participants report consuming prior to coming to Purdue. For Purdue News Service, I'm Jim Schenck.